Hello guys, welcome back to Kenya, Finland. Oh my god, I know it's been a minute, but I thought I could just come back and say hello and catch up with you guys. So how are you doing? How is life on your side? Yeah, I thought I could start back from my favorite place, which is the kitchen. And so I'm sure in most of your countries the COVID restrictions have been easing up and life is getting normal. Many people have been vaccinated, I believe. Travel has started again. In Finland, 80% of the population has been vaccinated, so life has normalized in many ways. So I don't know how about in your country. Please drop a comment. Let me know what's going on. What am I doing? I'm just trying to fry some mung beans. Fry some mung beans, which is like dengu, and then I'll make some rice and we'll catch up. I'm going to add some of this passata. Like, this is like minced tomato, like our tomato puree. And then I want to do a short segment about reflections, about like a little letter to myself, a letter to my 20-year-old self, or 20s, not 20-year-old, but 20s. Because guys, as you grow old, you learn so many things. It's like you've been in a deep dream and then boom, you wake up, you know. It's so real. It's nobody can prepare you for this, but so number one, so that was just black paper. You know guys, I use these containers, I love them. I don't see why we should use anything fancy. We just recycle here, we are environmental friendly. And I wanna use some potatoes and carrots. So number one, for my 20-year-old self, you're beautiful just as you are. In my 20s, I used to have a lot of self-image, like the wrong self-image. I used to feel very fat when I was actually skinny. I used to feel very dark when I was actually just a normal melanin girl. Thank God I never bleached. In my 20s, I used to feel like I'm not big enough in the right places, or I'm too big. You know, that, you know, just body image issues. Of course, driven a lot by what you see on social media and stuff. So I tell myself, you're beautiful just as you are. You don't need anything to add on to or anything to remove from that. And anybody who thinks otherwise, they don't need to be in your life. Okay? That's number one. Number two, I'd say, girl, stop wasting time with losers. I mean, in a good way. Like, you know those boys who just wanna waste your time telling you sweet nothings? Like, I was in so many useless relationships. Like, wow, when I look back, I'm like, I would have graduated in a PhD during that time. Bit of water. Yeah, like I would have just, if I put that time and energy to like actually study, oh my goodness, I would have, yeah, not that I'm not well studied, I'm well educated. Those who know me know that I'm well educated, and I'm thankful to God for that, but a lot of time was wasted. I should have hustled and or studied or traveled or whatever, but please, 20-year-old, stop wasting time with boys. It's not worth it. So, number three. Forgive my fingernails. They look horrible. Yeah, so number three, a letter to my 20-year-old or 20s. Stop trying so hard to fit in. You know, once you're older, a lot of these people will not be in your life anyway, so girl, it ain't worth it. It's not worth it, okay? So that's something else I tell myself. Yeah, stop trying so hard to fit in. Maybe we can go to the backyard a little bit as this is cooking. Yeah. So that's the backyard. So I was at number three. It's a bit chilly. Of course, if you know Finland, you know it's early winter. So it's not yet snowing, but it's quite chilly. Number four, a letter to myself, I would say. I said number three, stop trying to fit in. You really don't need to fit in any group. It's just a waste of time, right? It's just a waste of time. Just be you. Those who like you, well enough. Those who don't like you, well enough. And then stop chasing the trends. I know for a 20-year-old, he's like, are you serious right now? Yeah, stop chasing the trends. They're not worth it. Stop wasting money on what's trendy. Trendy shoes, trendy what, trendy this. You have to know all type of music. That's for what? For what? Okay? Chase knowledge. Chase useful knowledge. Like, who's the president of Botswana right now? Who is the... which country in the world leads in the best education system? How can you get there? Which country has the best, strongest human rights, women rights, child protection rights? Chase that type of knowledge. Stop chasing who's the hottest pop artist. Like, that's nonsense. And I know it sounds vague for someone who used to do it myself, but yeah, that's why it's a letter to myself. I'm losing track, but let's assume this is going to be number five. Stop wasting money. I used to work so much in my 20s and I made a lot of money, all of it in Levi shops, Levi jeans that I don't even think I needed. And you think that when you're wearing a label, everybody is going to see you and like respect. People don't care what you're wearing as long as you're well covered. People don't care. Stop wasting money on trying to be seen. In your 20s, people try so hard to be seen and so hard to be heard. It's not necessary. Use that money to explore the world, travel, see different types of cultures, how people live, and how you can better yourself. I traveled also in my 20s. I moved out from the country, from the continent actually. I went to live in a different continent. And I learned a lot. I learned a lot about different cultures and how people live in more modernized countries. Yeah. So number six, I don't want this video to be too long. Number six, a letter to my 20-year-old. Trust God. We worry too much about things that are not necessary. Trust God, put God first in everything that you do. I hope I can move this video a little bit. Just so you can enjoy the beautiful backyard. See the leaves, how they are falling and how beautiful they are. Yeah, so trust God.
trust God and leave everything to God. We worry too much. Oh, what's going to happen? Da da da. Where am I going to get this? Let God worry about that. Let God plan for that. Always be anchored to the source. They always say we struggle because we've moved away from the source, which is God. So, well, I don't want to make this like a preaching session. I hope someone can hear this and it can be helpful to them. Number seven, stop comparing yourself to other people. Stop. It's not necessary. Live your life. Just stop comparing yourself to others. You're unique and special, and you're just enough. Okay? Used to compare myself with others. If I was like that, maybe I'd get more jobs, I'd have more friends, I'd find more favor from my employer. Do things right. Those who are meant to see and appreciate your uniqueness will see and appreciate. Those who are not able to see the sparkle in you, it was not meant for their eyes to see. You need to have the right senses, right lenses to see properly. So some people have the wrong lenses. They can't see you. It's not your fault. It's not their fault. You're just not meant to be favorable for each other. Period. Accept that. Move on. Oh, number eight. Stop clinging on to people. Oh my goodness. I think I learned this very late in life, that it's not necessary to really cling on to people. Actually, it's not necessary at all to cling on to people. Let people go. If people are not good for you, if people are being toxic, you don't need them in your life. Just cut them off. Cut them off. Keep it moving. That's life. Later on in life, those friends you had in your 20s, if you're lucky, you'll have one or two of them still in your life. But for the most part, I believe you're not going to have any of them in your life. Yes, don't cling on to people. Their season in your life is over. Cut them off. Let them go and do it in peace. Forgive yourself. Forgive them if there's any grudges, and say a prayer for them and for yourself, and cut those ties. Don't cling on to toxic relationships. Let those people go. It's not necessary. Bye, bro. Bye. Bye, sister. Bye. You don't need all that shadiness in your life. Too much toxicity that brings self-doubt, that puts you down, bad mental health. Not necessary. I think next time we can go back to the house and check on our food. Yeah, that's how our food is looking. Let me clean up my hands so that we can continue with our session. Yeah, so I was talking about toxic relationships and clinging on to people, trying to belong. You don't need that, girl. When you're older, it will mean nothing, and you realize how much time you wasted. So let those people go. Let those friendship break. Cut that girl off. Forget about those people who hurt you. Forgive. Forgive. I think that's a number eight. Forgive. Please forgive and move on. Forgive even your relatives, your parents, your cousin who said some nasty stuff. Stop holding on to that pain. It's not worth it. It's only hurting you. It's only hurting you. Girl, brother, it's only hurting you. Oh, in 1921, this one said this. In 1942, this one said... Forgive them and move on. You're imprisoning yourself with those hurtful words. It's not worth it. Our potatoes are ready, which tells me it's time to add the moon. And here are our moon beans. Ta-ra! So, I don't think I wanna fry all of them. I think like that. That's enough for now. The rest I just freeze and use them when I'm ready. I don't like freezing my mung beans when they are fried. It's just me. And of course, for aroma, dried fried onions. If you've been in this channel for a minute, you know. There. So yeah, I said, forgive people, move on. That was number 8. Stop worrying so much. Number 9, please explore the world. Please travel. Please apply for scholarship. Please dream big. Dream big. Dream big. And take steps. You know, there's a scholarship to go to China to study. Did I mention that there was a scholarship to go study medicine in China when I was early in my 20s? And then I was like, oh my goodness, I'd rather go to the States. Yeah. I'm sure there are people who took the offer and they're doctors today. And I was qualified, duh. So the challenge was only to study Chinese language and get full scholarship. But I was like, I'm going somewhere else. I guess that was not my destiny, but I'm just saying, you know, in your 20s, you have time. That time you're wasting with friends, drinking and doing all kind of nonsense. You might as well just spend, you know, learning about learning a new language and getting those scholarships. You know, build your foundation in your 20s. Build your foundation. Stop trying to get pregnant. Stop drinking heavy. Stop intoxicating your body. In your 20s, you're the healthiest most often. Your body is really strong and you're very energetic. Use that energy to make money and save that money. How's about opening a savings account? How's about opening some savings schemes or some investment scheme with the low risk profiles? Yeah, I did catch up a bit late in life on that, but at least I did catch up. There are people who are still in the darkness. I'll reduce the heat. So just can marinate, or actually I just put it off. The heat in there is enough to make all these spices come together. And because I don't want to eat it right away, I just let it now, like, among beings, like Dengu needs time to absorb spices. So if you fry in a rush and eat, it's not tasty. So you want to fry and then let it sit there and absorb all the nice spices. And then when you eat, it's bueno. So I guess I've said a lot of things about a letter to myself. And stop partying. That's my last point. Just stop wasting time partying and stop wasting money and being in the wrong groups. And why? So that you can be seen as a cool kid. Who cares about cool kids? This life is hard. Okay, I don't believe life is hard, but life is hard if you don't live it right. Fact. Yeah? Life can get really hard. If you don't do things right. So, but life is not hard generally. I believe life is good. I believe life is a very beautiful journey, and should be a beautiful journey for everybody, despite the ups and downs, like any other path when you go to the forest for a walk. But it's beautiful. Life is beautiful. So be grateful, be very grateful, be very respectful. And my parting shot: teach yourself discipline. Teach yourself the discipline to show up on time. First of all, to show up. If you promise to be somewhere, be there. Show up on time. Be ready for the occasion. If you're going for a wedding, dress for a wedding. If you're going for sports, dress for sports. If you're going for to the office, please dress the part. Dress the part, act the part. And be responsible. If you promise clients you're going to send reports by two, they should be there. A meeting is one. Be there. Let nobody wait for you for meetings in the office or wherever. It's not nice. Teach yourself discipline. If you said you're not going out over the weekend, don't go out. Let nobody persuade you to do so. Teach yourself discipline. Discipline will get you so far in life, so far, and you'll be able to live with anyone and everyone. Teach yourself discipline. That's my parting shot. In your 20s, if you never learned anywhere else in life, teach yourself and exercise. Build that character. Discipline. Eat right. And do exercise. It's you'll see it when you're in your 40s. Yeah. Eat right. Hydrate with water, not Coca-Cola or ice cream or beer. No. hydrate with water. Normalize drinking water. Normal water. Okay? Yeah, that's my parting shot. Above all, keep God first. And as always, in Kenya, Finland, be good to your neighbors. Be kind to yourself. Help where you can. It was so nice to come back and make another video for you guys. I really missed you. If you've not subscribed yet, please subscribe. If you already subscribed, thank you very much. And I'll try to create more content. My life nowadays is very, very busy. I might share that one day why it's very, very busy nowadays, but it's super busy. So whenever I get a moment to put up a video and stuff, I'll do so. Other than that, toodles. Be safe, keep well, enjoy life. If you're in your 20s, don't make the mistakes some of us did, so that you can save yourself time of catching up. All right, bye-bye.